because we are really focused on helping our students acquire 21st century skills, and because we're a project-based school, we connect our students to partners within this community as often as we can. For example, we are doing a project right now on refugees and immigration. Through partnerships we had within the building and in the Memphis community, we were able to connect our students with migrants and refugees.
You guys left with a project idea kind of brewing in your mind for how you were going to take the challenge or the theme or the focus from the conversations you guys had with refugees and immigrants. You were supposed to take one of those and think about how you're going to creatively, uniquely come up with a project design, a museum piece, a gallery piece that would shed light on that issue. So,
project-based learning lends itself really well to interdisciplinary teaching. Today, for example, we're teaching together for an hour and a half because there's both English elements and AP Human Geography elements. The overall competency is lead one's learning, but more specifically, the subtopic is set a path. We have a big chunk of stuff they need to do for their project, and so they need to start figuring out what day they're going to do it on and how it kind of builds to this final product. Today, they're just kind of developing a plan, coming up with some ideas. That'll be more informal, trying to figure out where they fall. And then the actual assessment will be Friday when they have a prototype, and we'll be able to look at more specifically the certain standards.
Because we base the projects around specific competencies, the assignments that are related to those projects, there's a lot more of a deliberate linking of those tasks with the competencies.
All right, so today we're looking at our big competency that we're going to be focused on, which is lead one's learning. And a part of lead one's learning is setting a path with guidance. So you know that your end goal is to create this prototype on Friday. So we're going to start taking it into small chunks, and you're going to create your path and how to get this prototype done. And that's what we're gonna be looking at today.
With project-based learning, it's not this like one and done situation. And competency learning is the same way. It's more personalized for students. So for example, today we're doing like create your own plan. Some students come in with that skill just because they were taught it in eighth grade or in previous grades. Other students come in and have no idea what creating a plan means. They're used to getting deadlines and they sit down and they're told to do it.
If you look on develop your plan, once again, we restate the competency, which is you can make a plan for completing the tasks, including key activities and deadlines. You can identify whether certain steps require help, and you can guess how long each step will take.
So with project-based learning and the competencies, some students might struggle. They might be developing that competency on how to make a plan and how to execute it, where other students might be ready to be pushed on. So it really allows for students to get that individualized learning while they're still getting the same concepts. It's just at different levels. And the competencies make it easier to kind of measure that and look at it and have students understand it.
So we are now going to give you guys time to work on it. But for those of you who are like stuck in the mud, really confused on what to do, you want a sounding board, you're gonna come into this room over here. For those of you who are just ready to fly and get some stuff done, you're gonna stay in here. This is gonna be the quiet kind of area. If you need help, Mr. Dixon will be around. Over here, we're gonna bounce ideas. We're gonna close the garage door. We can be a little bit louder, talk to each other, get some, finalize our ideas so we can start moving forward.
There's a lot of movement compared to a traditional classroom. A lot of self-direction for students.
During this project, I'm working on lead one's learning. I think it's pretty cool because it'll teach me how to like manage my time wisely and like teach me how to stay on task and stay focused on what I need to do and how to get things done by myself.
As a teacher coming from more of a traditional school, struggling with students who just have a difficult time, whether it's, you know, reading or comprehension, to students with enrichment, this allows, as a teacher, me to create pathways that fit each student.
Okay, so I think your next step is exactly what you're doing, is decide like what you want the purpose of this thing to be, and then how or what elements you can research to help bring that to the forefront.
So it's easier to be like, okay, I can see that this student's struggling with this specific thing, we're gonna aim for this, whereas this student is doing really well, we're gonna aim and push them here. So I think that's one of the benefits, is it for a teacher, it makes it kind of easier to address individualized learning, which I used to think it was unrealistic.
You know, do we want to stop everyone for the students who are struggling, but we also don't want to leave them in the dust. We want to give them scaffolding and support that they need. So we always have students who are not quite working on the same things or at the same speed as some other students because they're coming back and they're getting some extra help. And then we also have students who are ahead, you know, who we are trying to find ways to kind of keep them continually challenged to go beyond, to revisit, to push to that next level.
So one of the main competencies we're working on now is design solutions. So the project for this quarter is the students constructing model rockets for the purpose of being able to transport humans to Mars and make life livable there. And then last week we hit them with a design challenge, like take these pieces of paper and create rockets of different size and different fin types, looking at total surface area and volume, more geometric concepts, and also looking at parabolic motion for the algebra students. And they'll be analyzing that data to modify their rocket designs. So the final assessment will be their actual 3D printed rocket. So they're gonna have a little bit of options, whether they can 3D print and then create using our laser etcher, so two-dimensional design, so they can build a larger scale rocket. But it'll be the rocket along with supported research and activities. So it really has been unique and neat for us to take our content, but let the project drive where the content needs to go. And really give them that authentic learning experience more than just memorize these formulas and take a test on them next week.
That's what we want to find, because that's our max. Yeah. What trig function should we use?
X over 22.
Algebra, you ready?
Yeah.
We want X by itself, how we get it?
One thing that I love about project-based learning and competency-based learning is it gives students the time to actually be able to catch themselves up in places that they may have gaps. Maybe sometimes if it's necessary, especially in mathematics, if they need to build up that procedural fluency, just give them some practice problems to work out.
I feel like at traditional public schools, the teachers, like, they'll all give you the exact same piece of paper and stuff, and they'll all expect you, like, to understand it and, like, get it done all at the same time. And with this school, if you need more time, you can go talk to your teacher about it, and I love the way that they teach, because I have a learning comprehension issue, and the way that they teach, it, like, helps me with that, because, like, if you need help, they'll help you one-on-one.
It really opens up the opportunity for equity across the board because it allows students of any ability level to enter where they are and grow to where they need and want to be.